Summer is here. If you want to know how to make summer service on your air conditioning properly, this video is for you. Let's go for it.
On this video, I'm going to show you step by step how do I complete maintenance to an air conditioning unit and what to expect when you pay for this type of service. I'm a service technician with over 10 years of experience. Currently, I'm working for a well-known company in South Georgia. I will respect your property and I will provide you excellent service. This maintenance is not very complicated. Anybody can do it, but you will have some risk involved. I'm not encouraging you to do it yourself. This video is for educational purposes. I start checking the air filters and cleaning the filter returns. This part is one of the most important and most overlooked maintenance by homeowners and technicians. Today, customer did not have the filters, so I told them to get new ones and install them as soon as possible. Second, I go to the air handler unit, I cut the power off, and I check the condition of the high voltage wires. If they are loose, they will need to be tightened. In that way, you avoid fire hazards. Then I check the condition of the evaporator coil. This one is very clean, but I like to use this product that is in a spray, is a non-rinsable cleaner with a very good citrus smell. I continue using condensate tablets on the primary drain pan that will reduce the algae on the drain line.
If you do this type of maintenance regularly, I guarantee you that you will extend the life of your unit.
On the blower section, I look for loose wires or burnt wires. On this unit, during this service, I found that the insulation of the door of the cabinet, it was separated. So I went out to my van, I used a spray adhesive to put it back in place. After making sure that everything looked good, I continued to put everything back together. It's good to know to clean the outside panels. It doesn't matter how hard you work, but if what the customer sees is dirty for them, you didn't do anything. Continuing, I found leaves on the inside of the condenser unit. If they are not removed and cleaned, they will rot and may cause a refrigerant leak. And again, I cut the power off to start checking the outside components. On this side is a simple setup. Air handler is in a closet and the condenser coil is at ground level. And your place may be different, but after watching this video, you can have an idea on how a proper maintenance is done. The process will be the same for every unit.
This capacitor is weak on the fan side. It's reading 3.5 of 5, so it needs to be replaced. Let me come back, I'll put a new one.
I want to thank you if you made it this far on this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. I want to make more videos to share what I know with you. Remove the fan part to have full access and remove all dirt, leaves from the inside of the condenser cabinet. I use water to rinse the coil from the inside out and then around the whole unit, being careful of not putting water on the electrical components. If coils are very dirty, I may use cleaner, but in this case, it was not necessary. I proceed to clean the drain line with a wet vacuum. After it's clean, you will need to prime the P-trap, in that way the unit can drain. I like to use a mix of water with bleach. I really like this insulation. Look, this filter was installed on the inside and it was protected from the rain and the water and the sun. After having the unit maintained, turning all power on, and running the unit for a good 15 minutes, I hook my instruments to get information of the performance of the unit. At this time, this unit is within manufacturer specs.
Thank you for watching my videos. I hope you learned something new. Don't be a pirate, and let's follow me for the next adventure.